Doon sinabol ni Ma'am Shoes. Kung di nyo kilala si Ma'am Shoes, si Oh My Venus po yun si Ma'am Shoes. Sinabol ng Eve ng real world manipulation. So we might see that kind of gameplay on the side of GNA. And tulad nga ng hinanap ko sa kanina na Chang'o, there's it. The Chang'o on the side of GNA Esports.
Ayan na, binagbigyan na tayo, Baymax. Pero of course, Juicy Legends Road to Pro tayo. Kaya pati ang mga galawan talagang pang pro moves na rin as well. Reach Apex though, ano ang pwede nilang ipang counter sa isang Aldous, Baymax?
Alam mo, as an Aldous main, no, na
ano, anong ranking? Anong ranking?
Wala eh. Kasi laging talo, paano magkakaroon ng rank? Hindi, joke lang guys. Isa sa mga madaling ipang-counter kay Aldous is someone na mabilis maka-escape. No, ano, panchani ba? Pag tinawag natin panchani-chani, hit, escape, hit, escape, hit, escape. Cho! One of the good example is gonna be a Cho dito. Someone who could escape the stun coming from the Aldous can survive a full combo din, no? And kung actually take down Aldous on the other hand, the problem is, pag maagang nakapag-stack up yung Aldous natin dito, Maring Atina, that's gonna be a huge problem. You do have the Uranus, yes, pero mostly of the lineup ng Rich Apex is gonna be quite squishy.
Yes. Pag napabayaan talagang isang Aldous, kumakate. The more that he gets more stuck, the more aggressive he gets. But at the same time though, lineup-wise, who are you siding with? Pero bago kita pasagutin, Uy, is Philippines number 5, Jawhead na ang nilabas dito ni Sway.
Nako. Parang ano ah. Parang dahil doon sa Philippines number 5, napunta ako sa ano ah. Sa Rich Apex dito, Maring at Ina. Pero mostly on the lineup, tulad nga nasabi ko kanina, it's gonna be on how they execute the lineup. This is an Aldous. A double-edged sword kung tawagin natin. Bakit double-edged? It could work and it couldn't. Maybe it couldn't work. Pwedeng gumana, pwedeng hindi. No, bakit pwedeng gumana, pwedeng hindi? Jawhead, Ken. Go on to jungle of the enemy team, tapos harasin lang ng harasin, i-reset ng i-reset.
Exactly.
Hindi kasi masyadong mabilis mag-clear ng jungle camp ang isang Aldous, guys. Pero eto, let us go into the land of dawn. It is gonna be game number 3 para sa JNA Esports and Reach Apex. Maring Atina, back to you.
Hindi po yan. Sige na, Baldes! Energy! Kasi siya ng Juicy Lemon.
Na.
O para may ka-ano ko na nakabos. Wala
pa ka siyan eh.
Ethel Buba! Siyempre. Oh, doon na to!
Energy! Hindi si Ethel Buba, Sarupa May! Parang Sarupa May Ginto!
Atina May!
Atina May Ginto ka na pala ngayon!
Ito na yung sinasabi natin. So, way with the jawhead, very, very frightening. He could go for the early denial as well as early na pang-haras dito sa JNA Esports Baymax.
Yes, and look at this. Speaking of haras, bottom lane, si Alidap ang hinaharas ng Koya Mokeblar with that Pakito na alam naman natin gaano kadalas makalabang when it comes to melee heroes. Pero, oy, Ejector didn't connect against Kevlar. Oh. That was a fail gank onto the bottom lane.
Guys, potensya dun. Pero sito, todo na natin to as we head on dito sa may bandang top lane and even sa orange pop. Look at Demon Kite here. Being ejected out of his own territory. Ito na yung sinasabi natin pang dedenay, guys. Yung few seconds sa yun, it makes a huge difference. But look at the counter go here against Kevlar. But still, that is a Pakito. Close range ang gustong labanan niya. But at the same time, Bacardi 151 clearly and the best position as a first blood being secured right now by Demon Kite. Pero there will be an almost off-cam kill naman for Kevlar. 2-0 agad, Baymax.
Is that good? No, that didn't look good para sa akin, Maring Atina. That's a huge mistake coming from the side of JNA. Pero look at the bottom lane! That was almost a reverse kill or reverse takedown para sa side ng JNA. Luckily, nakasurvive ang tropa natin na si Ryzen. Pero babalik tayo to the fact na nakakuha ng kill ang isang Aldous. Yes, hindi yung stacks, but still, you give him enough gold para makabuo ng kanyang mga core items which he needs to stack up much faster. All he needs are items with cooldown reduction. Endless battle. Yes. Diba? Once na nagka-endless battle na to, the cooldown reductions are there, the damage is stacking up, mas mabilis siya makakapag-stack, pero as of now, a teamfight might happen.
Uy, pero dito, counter go with the river manipulation, pero siya mismo yung shinot down dito. But of course, he would not go down without a fight as Bacardi 1-1 with the wave of the dragon against Paquito. Dito si Trevor medyo napitbitan ng sumani with a split-split combination against the wave. Pero mukhang si Demon Kite is having the time of his life against the hyper carry of Reach Apex. Away will fall as well. Trevor right now doing a great job against the side of Reach Apex as they managed to get hyper carry this early as possible. Baymax, not down. Naku po.
3 minutes into the game, we're at 5-3 with the 2-0-2 Aldous. That's gonna be hard for you. Dalawa na yun iti-takedown niya, and si Ryzen ang nabatukan niyang isa pa. Pero we have the dragon coming in from the top lane.
Oh, that Sonata will connect to onto Glue, pero dito is may bandang jungle side. Susundan pa ba nila? Sway still has the ejector though. Kailangan umuwi ni Eren. If not, they could go for a counterplay. At instead, let's focus on the bottom side as well.
Yes.
Kevlar with the Paquita. Very, very frightening. Pero sabi mo nga, pwede rin naman siya counteran dito na Chew. But look at that counter-strike here, or counter-strike. Pero with a knockout strike as well with the jab. Makaka-survive pa rin naman dyan.
Makaka-survive. Kayang-kayang sumurvive, yes. But ang magiging kapalit nun is hindi niya mamamaximize yung kanyang average. Kasi most of the time, he's gonna be backing up, regenerating his life. Masasayang yung mga oras na pwede niyang i-proc out yung average niya. Which is a good thing naman para sa side ng JNA Esports. Speaking of JNA Esports, as of now, hindi pa rin nasa-shutdown yung Claude natin. But yes, we've seen that in terms of teamfight, nakakasabay yung Reach Apex. And what they're doing right now is trying to pick off the enemy team one by one. Look at that, onto the bottom lane.
Speaking of pickup, look at the Sonata connecting off to Kevlar with the Rondo and Rhapsody securing a kill yet again for Reach Apex. And there is a huge objective na naman na secured on the Demon Kite onto the top lane. Another turtle up for grabs. Trevor here with a split fleet. I'm watching where he goes in with the Sanid as well. Tuko na nga moment pa. Hindi pa nga yata mag-enough na Ryzen. Will be the target right now, pero hindi pa yata magiging enough yung damage output niya as Ryzen just goes in, continues his life.
Oh,
pero si Demon Kite with a normal and killing spree will be secure for Demon Kite, pero ejector combination with unstoppable force will secure a shutdown kill for Sway against Demon Kite. Pero dito hindi pa tapos ang boxing as Alidap tries to go out and secure a kill against CJ, pero dito
Billboard
manipulation. But there is a perfect timing for Riku with the Power of Order and Power of Chaos against JNA Esports, and that will clearly be in favor of Reach Apex, and a power up move indeed, at na power up at the boost up pa ng Juicy Lemon, pero hindi pa tapos as another ejector will result into a kill, and that will be another one for Reach Apex. Grabe.
But tama rin, Atina, we've seen na nakakalawang sila in terms of kill, in terms of team fights. Pero look at the gold. The net worth of both of the team are super close to each other na hindi mo ramdam na lamang yung Reach Apex in terms of kills. And lamang sila sa kills, yes, pero JNA on the other hand, lamang in terms of objective. As well as map control. But lamang sila sa map control kasi look at this. Talagang papalag muna sila dito sa may bottom line.
Papalag si Riku, nagwawala na parang wala nagbabantay. Clearly, kahit na sinalita na siya dito, but Demon Kite here with a normal attack will be able to shut him down. Dito si Sway, wala na yata magagawa kundi mag-undergo na lang. Pero as dito, si Demon Kite will contain himself. Aaron is doing great job, yes.
Oh,
with a meteor shower, sinasala-sala lang dito na Reach Apex, pero nagkahiwalay sila ng landa.
Parang
yung karagatan. Pero dito si Demon Kite, yung bawat suntok niya talagang bumabaw na ganyan sa Reach Apex. Kevlar doing great job with the knockout strikes. Magkakaroon ba ng perfect pick-up? I don't think so. As Reach Apex slowly retreats back. JNA Esports, pero si CJ dito being aggressive right now, trying to spot on kung sino man po position dito. Bacardi onto the back of Demon Kite. Maiispata ni Trevor. Will he go for another objective? Yes, I don't think so. Pero this is CJ, yung reward manipulation niya will do. As Rico just goes in and tear apart his HP. Trevor and Ryzen right now being...
Naku!
Blue with a split with the combination, but Sway here with a supple force and ejector combination against Aaron Trevor and a lead dap dap as a Demon Kite makakasecure ng kill. Bacardi 1-1 with the wave of the dragon against the high Demon Kite, pero hindi niya pakakayanin yan. Kahit na masakit, may kakunatan din yan. And clearly guys though, even though nadikit tayo pagdating sa mga patayan, pati sa network, Baymax, what's happening right now? Why is it balanced out?
It is indeed balanced out because of the objectives and the gold platings na maximize ang GNA Esports. I've seen the Chang'o being left alone onto the middle lane, taking down all of the gold plates by himself. By himself kasi Aren or lalaki yung gumagamit sa kanya, guys. Pero look at the item. Chang'o with the ice skin 1 directly going for that holy crystal. Aldous, instead of going for the endless battle, going a little bit tanky with this build, Thunderbelt ang kanyang kinuha dito. Quite understandable knowing na si Ryzen with the 4-3-3 din yung score natin dito. Glue and Pakito going a little bit tanky as well with that Deadly Blade pa kay Pakito. Just enough to counter Alidap on the teamfight sa bottom lane. Whereas onto the side of Reach Apex, we do have the Cho going for the endless battle with the Blade of Heptasy. Granger going for the BOD with the Brute Force, and Lunox nearing that Lightning Truncheon na merong Clock of Destiny. Pero look at this. The damage output of Demon Kite is still not that high because that's a Johead. But remember na hindi niya pa na ma-maximize yung kanyang suntok o yung One Punch Man ng ating Aldous dito. Once na ma-maximize niya yan and magamit niyang makalasit ng hero, that's gonna be the start of the problem ng Reach Apex dito. Luckily, most of the time, contra killer lang yung nakaka-kill or yung kanyang ultimate, no? Hindi yung stacking skill niya. Pero, no? Pero, andun pa rin yung problema. That's still an Aldous na nakakakuha ng item.
The Chase Fate has a perfect timing. He not only uses it in pickoffs, he also uses it in responding to different kinds of lane. Kaya pati yung map control, nahahawakan nila. But right now, they need to do something to stop yet again si Demon Kite. Another turtle right now up for grabs, and this is actually the last turtle of the game. Look at Sui here spotting Trevor. That will be a 4v1 situation. But will there be a contest? I don't think so.
Demon
Kite just goes in and gets a big objective and a turtle buff as well. Pero dito sa may bandang bottom side, Rich Apex just focusing on the big objectives. Kebler with a flicker combination, pero may shotgun siya dito ni Alitap. Look at Trevor here with a split pick combination. Makakasanib na parang toko, mabablicker out lang. Then Void Crystal will not connect as well as in Void Blast.
Pero this
is way with the perfect targeting against CG, and Trevor will fall down. Rainbow manipulation, that will be a minute too late as Rich Apex goes in with a clean 2 pick off on the bottom side. Demon Kite na ispatan sila adapt-dap, pero wala na siya magagawa. He needs setups para makapasok siya with the counter punches Baymax. Pero right now, he's being harassed with the ejector combination. All the damages are being sponged out right now. Sumusuntok, yes, pero parang kasumusuntok sa kawalan. Kevlar here trying his best to zone him out, but a double kill will be secured by Ryzen with the Granger. And clearly, Baymax, was that team fight that they should have fight with?
Actually, they shouldn't have fought that team fight. Mm-hmm. Bakit? Aldous was still farming at the jungle camp. Tapos Pakito wasted a full potential na manakout strike yung dalawang hero na kanyang kaharap. I think that was kind of a miscommunication, pero kaya pang bumawi ng JNAD. Still have the Chang'o na bihira ko pa maita sumama sa clash, no? Though Lunox or si Riku ng side ng Reach Apex is starting to go online as well, that's gonna be a problem. Na-realize ng Reach Apex na we can't fight them without a complete members. So, what we need to do is before we initiate a team fight, make sure that we're still above at least 4 person, and yun yung ginagawa nila. Most of the time, bago sila mag-initiate, they're making sure na apat silang magkakasama. And mostly, bottom lane yung pinaka nagiging target nila. Bakit bottom lane? Because most of the time, nakikita nila yung Aldous nagpa-farm onto the top lane. Making sure na ligtas siya, hindi siya mahahunt down ng Reach Apex. Pero I think, nagkaroon ng advance mag-isip, kumbaga, yung Reach Apex na, hihiwala yung Aldous. Matatagalan bago humanap ng target yung contract niya. So, dito tayo sa baba para hindi agad siya makaresponde.
Dito sa may bandang baba si Trevor na kumapit na parang toko kay Aladapdap. Uy, back away na lang din. I like the idea. Sabi mga nagkakaroon ng two steps thinking forward dito sa Reach Apex. But what does JNA Esports needs to do to balance it out? Kasi kanina balance out, ngayon mas nakakalamang si Reach Apex, Baymax, in terms of network and as well as turret takedowns.
Actually, mahihirapan talaga silang i-balance out to because as of now, team control is on the side of Reach Apex or yung map control natin. Pero Aldous, using his ultimate dito, Chase Fate?
Chase Fate magkoconnect dito, pero Wave the Dragon as well with the counter-go combination. But look at Aerie here, managing on a Ryzen! Injure, pero dito si Trevor being harassed by 4 members. Pinapaligira ka na with the ejector, and normal attacks from the Chaos Assault will secure a kill. At the same time though, JNE Esports, is this a window that they need? They managed to take down Ryzen without sacrificing Demon kahit Baymax. And they stopped the Lord Take.
Yes, they did. Yes, Rita, GNA Esports did a good job doon sa pag-initiate, especially kay Demon Kitay. Wala siyang takot na ginamit yung ultimate niya para pumasok sa gitna ng kalaban, knowing na I'm a bit tanky, why not I make some kind of play or some kind of initiation na magiging reason para makalaman kami. And that indeed happened. Aren, di ba? Perfectly using that meteor shower against Ryzen na walang nang no choice kundi yes, magtutumakbo na lang din dun sa likod. But sadly, because meron nga tayong Winter Trancho, Ice Queen 1 to slow him down, eh, hindi niya na nailagan pa. We're 13 minutes into the game, 11-18 ang score with just 2k gold lead in favor of Reach Apex as they try to initiate another team fight.
Another split speed with the slam sa magkoconnect dito inside the real world manipulation. Immobilized na sila off-side pero makakatapos pa rin. At the same moment though, hindi tinatantana ni Trevor si Sway pero hindi rin siya tatantana with a Jackson combination counter though. He will not survive as a death sonata will connect into his face. Pero Baymax, ito na yata naman ang kinakatakutan ng JNA Esports. Yes, they do have the Aldous, but pagdating sa late game, a Granger is still a Granger.
Tama
the
ka dyan,
position as well. Grabe, pero speaking of position dito, si Kevlar, mapasama yata hindi. Pero si Bacardi, 1-5-0. Thankfully though, that he still has a flicker to disengage, but a second level Lord. Kasi Luminous Lord na to, guys, ha? Kasi nag-abot na tayo sa 12 minute mark, even though this is the first Lord. This is a Luminous Lord, which means na kahit papano, may epekto na to on to JNA Esports. Will they be able to defend this one out, Baymax?
Actually, they can because they have the Chang'o. And one more thing about that very last teamfight that happened before the Lord. Nakita natin, nag-contract chase fate yung Aldous natin, Maring Athena. But he stopped it, no? So, ang nangyari, si Trevor lang mag-isa yung naiwan dun sa backline. Sabi ko, bakit naiwan si, bakit kinancel niya yung chase fate niya? Knowing na nakapag-initiate na si Trevor, yung pala, they wanted to try and take down Chu. But sadly, it didn't happen. And that's a miscommunication thing para side ng JNA Esports. Isa yon sa mga dapat nilang iwasan. Those kind of miscommunication plays would lead to their demise against Reach Apex. Tulad nito.
Pero dito si Trevor pinagtutulungan para look at the Demon kahit being harassed by four members in your soul still. But hindi ma rin magiging enough yan. Walang malakas sa lima. Tumatapat ng gano'n. At the same moment, no, si Mozart talaga ang mga bakbakan, pati pagsalunan ng Detsonata, parang sa pagkain lang ni Prof. B. si Mozart din. To the bones, parang sa juicy lemon niya kanina. Kitang-kita ko, inangat niya pa yung baso.
Inangat pa, oo. Talaga naman sila Mozart. Karang yung mga buhay dito ng JNE Esports na masisimot ng mga miyembro ng Reach Apex. Ayan na.
Doon yata sina napapasama. That is clearly a misposition. Sinalo nila lahat ang meteor shower dito na nanggagaling kay Aaron, the silent worker kumbaga na tinatawag namin ni Coach Leo as well, with a 2-0-4 KDA Trevor with a split-split. Pwede na siya sumanib anytime soon dito kay Bacardi. 1-5-1. Ito na nga yung sinasabi natin. It's crazy. Activate na rin dito ni Aldous or ni Demon kahit as he goes in with a B4 combination. So still almost up an HP left. Sip pa yan pa ng river manipulation combination slaying off Ryzen is way will be the last man standing for Reach Apex ejector. Yes, there will be it. Pero si Trevor ang eject out niya. This might be the comeback that JNA Esports needs. Will they be able to finish this one out? The base start outer middle lane successfully taken down by JNA Esports. Another meteor shower sway immortality has been poked up, and as well as a kill for JNA Esports. Power of order ikokomit agad ni Riku and Alidap, the last man standing on the base of Reach Apex. Will they be able to defend this one out against JNA Esports, Baymax?
They would by a little, no? Bakit a little? Kung nagkataon na medyo may karamihan pa yung mga minions ng JNA, that could have been the end of the game. But luckily, isang catapult minion lang yung bit-bit nila doon. And look at the itemization dito ng Aldous natin. Tulad na sabi ko, he goes for a tanky build. Diba? Makikita natin dito with the Oracle and the Brute Force Breastplate. Talaga na po mahihirapan o matatagalan bago siya mamatay. And with that amount of stacks, it is enough para makahunt down siya ng isang Ryzen or ng Granger. On the other hand, speaking of Granger, knowing na medyo makunat yung ating Aldous, he has gone for the Malefic Roar instead of going for the BOT. And this might be the last item going to be an immortality for the safetiness na rin ng isang Ryzen. We've all seen that every team fight siya talaga ang nagiging hunted down ng Aldous natin dito as they try to initiate another teamfight sa bot lane.
Meteor Shower, sinasalo-salo nila Rico and Trevor here. Nakikipag 1v1 sa Tatahana. Ejector combination will be used. Ali, dap, dap. Look at that. Uy, meron siyang shield unit. Yata magiginap as another reward manipulation combination from Aaron's Meteor Shower will secure into kill for JNE Esports. This will be a 5v4 situation. Pati yung purple buff hindi na hinahayaan pa mahawakan dito ni Ryzen. Trevor is doing a great job as well, Baymax, in using that glue to sponge in all the damage na binibigay ng Rich Apex. Grabe naman yun.
Sa sobrang grabe ng mangyayaring yun, maring Athena, napapawaw si Prof B doon sa may ano natin, sa backscreen natin dito. Pero look at this, another team fight might happen onto this jungle or sa Lord Camp as JNE Esports tries to take it away from the hands of Rich Apex. Pero this is definitely going to be a contest match. Nako, Chase Space Contact na nga dito kay Bacardi.
Si Bacardi 151 pinagtutulungan dito, talagang pinaatras lang siya.
Nakapakapito si Ryzen
here, Trevor, with the split screen combination. Immortality has been proc'd for Ryzen. Sinalo niya lahat doon na Meteor Shower together with the Rainbow Manipulation, and the double kill will be secured by Aaron with ejector combination against Demon Kite's Way will be the next one down as JNE Esports takes three members off of Reach Apex, and that is indeed the power of move for Juicy Lemon. Talagang pag nag Juicy Lemon ka, makaka-win streak ka, pero matutuloy kaya ang win streak dito ng JNE Esports as they march towards the middle lane. Leaguer will be there and Kevlar with the knuckle strikes will take down the Lunox or si Riku, and this, ladies and gentlemen, game number 3 will be secured by JNE Esports against Reach Apex.
The communication of Reach Apex, every Reach Apex members dito is there. Pero ibang klase yung communication na hawak ng JNA. Look at that very last play na ginawa ni Kevlar. Siguro, or feeling ko, ang ginawa niya doon, pre, papasukin ko, I have flicker, I have knockout strike na pwedeng inakap. Let us dive in para wala nang dumepensa. And there you have it, poof, it became nothing. Turned into dust yung huling dumepensa dito. But still, good job para sa Reach Apex kasi magandang laban pa rin na kanilang pinakita. They almost won this fight, this fight, but let's hear kung ano nga bang masasabi ni paring Prof B.
The reverse sweep is real. Sinasabi nga dito ng mga tropa natin, pinabalik yung mga Reach Apex sa ano, sa World of the Apex. Doon ay sa World of the Apes, sabi dito ng mga tropa natin, JNA. Kasi ang hirap nga naman, no? Eh gumagana kasi etong si Demon Kite or si Demon Kite, yun nga naman sasabihin ko, no? Tapos gusto ko yung idea na binibitaw dito ni ano, ni feeling ko may kasalanan talaga actually si Baymax. Si Baymax kasi nagbigay nung idea kung paano ginagawa yung play na nasa top lang si Aldous. Well, the basic idea nga naman, eh, lumayo kayo sa Aldous kasi pag nag-contract siya, alam nyo kung saan manggagaling, di ba? Tapos yung jutsu na sama-sama jutsu, kumbaga yung barkadahan package. Pagka, syempre, pagka magbabarkada kayo, barkada package A, di ba? Sama-sama jutsu lang yan, which is, eh, ang hirap naman, di ba? Yun yung kinakounter nila dito. Kaso, nagkapanta.